In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to use AccuGL 2 Companion Mode. This feature will allow a user to easily send data to an Excel worksheet as it is collected. You can activate Companion Mode using the toggle switch located in the upper right corner of the window. Excel will automatically open alongside AccuGL 2. We will start by copying the output headers to the data sheet. To do this, we need to download the example template from the RadCal site under Support AccuGL Software. Click on Sample Templates and download AG2 Template Example for AutoLink. Open the template and select rows 5 and 6, then copy. Back on the Companion Mode sheet, we will paste in cell A1. The example template can be closed when finished. We will need to select a cell where we want the data to be placed. After selection has been made, we can go back to AccuGL 2 and click the Get Cell button and check the Auto Send box. The unit of measure cannot be adjusted for data that has been exported. They can be manually adjusted using the setting options. Here we can set the dose and the dose scale unit of measure. Now that Companion Mode is ready for use, you can begin measuring to collect data. Data outputs can be linked to any cell in a template by selecting the destination cell and creating a cell reference to the data sheet if you are creating a report. To demonstrate, we'll use a blank sheet. I will set up three outputs. The first will be time. Select the cell under the header and press the equals key. Then go back to the data sheet and select the beginning output cell under the time header and then press enter to set the reference. We will repeat for kV and dose. You'll not need to set the reference for each cell manually. We can set the range by selecting the outputs. You will see a small box at the lower right corner of the selected cell. This box is referred to as a fill handle. You can click and drag the fill handle to automatically set the following references. If you would like to separate the measurements by test section, you can use the Get Cell button to reposition the output to a different row. By default, the software uses seconds as a time base. If you'd like to use milliseconds, you can multiply the time output by 1,000 using the formula bar. To do this, select a starting cell, then click on the formula bar and add asterisk 1,000, then press Enter. We can use the fill handle to apply the multiplier to the following time output cells.